Yesterday, me and my daughter were out. We wanted to soak up all the cold and the snow we could in the Vancouver downtown, and I was so freaking excited. We were taking lots of pictures and videos, but very often my phone was switching off and I was like, this is my new iPhone. Why it is turning off a lot? And I didn't knew a reason at all. Trust me, I literally didn't know the reason. So as soon as we came back home, I googled about it, why it is happening, and the reason was so freaking good. So here's the reason why it was happening. And I got to know that this is not a flaw with Apple products. This happens with any lithium ion battery powered devices. Apple designed the iPhone to turn off under extreme conditions such as very cold or very hot weather. This actually helps protect your iPhone from malfunctioning as a result of low voltage from the battery. Apple recommends that you only use your iPhone or any other iOS devices when the temperature is between 32 to 95 degrees Fahrenheit, just to avoid temperature related issues. That time I got the butterflies in my stomach and I was so proud that I have an iPhone now. Absolute thanks to my husband Nimish. Hey guys, if you're watching me for the first time, I'm Pragya Gautam, and thank you so much for giving me so much of love in my previous review video. It was so much fun to see all the comments and the likes over there, and that was a Canon T6 Rebel T6 review, camera review, and I'm so excited for today's video as well. This is unboxing and review video of iPhone XS by the title, you know now. So yeah, let's start with the video.
Alright folks, so it has been more than 30 days we had bought this new family member iPhone XS in our life for the first time. The iPhone XS is a silver in color and 256GB phone. It has came with AirPods with a lightning connector, lightning to USB cable, and USB power adapter. There are some basic features which I absolutely love, and they are Face ID, that means your phone recognizes your face to unlock, authorizes Apple Pay payments and perform other tasks. Number two is Control Center, so swipe down from the upper right corner to quickly take a photo, turn on room lights, control music, portrait orientation lock, Wi-Fi, mobile data, torch and more. Then on third number is a home, which is a swipe up to go to home, which is so easy. On left side of the body has two button and one switch. The top one is a switch to choose ring or silent, either of it. Then two buttons are there to adjust audio volume. Just to wake your phone up, you can tap anywhere on the screen. It has 3D touch. You can access menus, shortcuts and content by pressing the screen with the 3D touch. Right side of the body has one button which has three functions. A, press once to wake or sleep. B, press twice to activate Apple Pay. C, press and hold to turn on iPhone or activate Siri. In emergency, press and hold the side button of either of a volume button to turn off iPhone or make an emergency call. Now let's move towards the specifications to know and love iPhone XS more. Just like me, in case if you're wondering what the Retina OLED in the world is, then Retina Display is a brand name used by Apple for its series of IPS LCD and OLED displays that have a higher pixel density than traditional Apple displays. The goal of the Retina display is to make the displays a display of a text and the images extremely crisp, so pixels are not visible to the naked eye. So now let's move towards camera, picture and video quality. So trust me or not, most of us, when we see the specification or just go through any new mobile phone, we check our camera quality first. At least I do it, and if you agree on that, then comment down below, yes I do. So it will be really fun to see all those comments, and I will surely will feel like we have a tribe. Okay, so now I'm going to show you all the videos and pictures I took in iPhone XS, and with that I'll be explaining you all the specification which I also did not know, and that is 4K resolution, also called as 4K, and refers to an horizontal display resolution of approximately 4000 pixels. You guys might have seen my recent videos on YouTube channel, like Day in My Life video, Canada Life video, and right now also you're seeing my iPhone camera video only and the pictures only. So let me tell you, I'm literally obsessed with my camera, iPhone XS camera. But why am I obsessed with that? Here are the reasons. The cameras are better, especially in the low light, and the new depth control of the portrait works really well. Slow motion video though, my goodness, you can take even a screenshot from a slow motion video and edit it a little bit, and trust me, you will have some real good captures ever. iPhone XS has nailed in the quality. It is great in close-up photos, and especially I love how it takes photos with a real good exposure, and the way it captures yellow in the back, I love it. It definitely delivers more detail in the picture. So now let's have a comparison between iPhone XS and Samsung S8 picture quality. Honestly, you can see the depth of the picture, and I think iPhone definitely rocked it. Sound. Okay, so now let's move towards a speaker and microphone. Okay, when you will turn on the audio in the iPhone, you will definitely avoid connecting it to the earpods or any other Bluetooth speaker because they are surprisingly very amazing. Audio in iPhone XS is sweeter stereo. I have explained more about the sound quality in details on my website in a blog. So head over to www.gautampragya.com if you are interested in learning more about it. The video's voiceover I have done in my iPhone XS only of this video. So I'm sure that you already are impressed and you do not want any other explanation about it. Now let's talk about battery life. If you know me a little bit from my YouTube video or social media, I'm not a big fan of spending hours and hours behind the phone and playing game. Trust me, I used to when I was not a mom. So if you're a person who for any reason does not spend hours on the phone, you will be very happy with the battery life too. For me, I charge once in every 24 hours. Mostly I put in charge when I go to bed at night. 100% of charged battery lasts for more than 24 hours for me. I'm not joking. So in the bottom line, I would say iPhone XS is one of the best phone and deal in the price range it is coming for sure. If you're among those people who are either thinking of purchasing iPhone for the first time in the life just like I did, or still holding off on upgrading your iPhone 7 or iPhone 6s, do not think twice for spending on iPhone XS, trust me. Also the cameras are miles better, especially in the low light. In between iPhone XS and iPhone XS Max, I would definitely recommend iPhone XS Max because of screen size, which is 6.5 if you can afford and hold in one hand, obviously. But for me, I preferred iPhone XS because I wanted a one-handed friendly one and my hands are very small, trust me.
Thank you so much for watching today's video, and this was all about today's review, and I really hope that you enjoyed. And if yes, make sure to give this video a like. This means a lot. I really get excited with the number of likes. I don't know why, but I like the blue thumbs a lot. And also make sure to share it with your friends on Instagram and Facebook, so it will be so much fun. And tag me, definitely tag me if you buy iPhone XS or XS Max. So yeah, I will repost that video and or photo, whatever you're posting. It will be so much fun to do that. And write me in the comment section which iPhone or smartphone do you own and why do you like it. So yeah, so many people will get the ideas that they should buy or not. So yeah, give me the reason in the comment section why you own it, and yeah, what do you think about that. So that's all for today's video. Thank you so much. Here's Nelvi. Thank you so much for watching today's video, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.